Something's in the. I wanted to make a very timeless record that wasn't just timeless in terms of what other people thought, but really just timeless for myself. And, you know, I gathered a lot of inspiration from a lot of older artists that I grew up loving, and, you know, mostly Julie London and a lot of Frank Sinatra and Peggy Lee. And then the songs in the album are all over the place and very, I think, versatile and different to one another, but also are very cohesive, which is like a big goal for me, is to make things feel like the same project, but not like the same song over and over again. The main thing that I would hope is for people to hear what I say and then go, oh God, I feel like that. I didn't know that I felt like that, but this is how I feel. And maybe, you know, make a change in their life that makes them happier. I don't want to get too specific because I think it's really for the listener to decide. I don't want to put the ideas into their brains because I want them to feel 100% that their own interpretation is the right interpretation. There was so much self-reflection in the making of this album that I think really comes through the songs, and self-reflection on myself and reflection on things I've experienced or witnessed. But the process was very natural and felt good and satisfying. Whereas before, you know, I was always felt under pressure and anxious and felt like I wasn't doing enough, you know, right, or doing a good job, or, you know, this isn't good enough. And I felt like I wasn't very talented also at the time, and I actually feel much more confident in my craft now, and I feel that I've worked really hard on that. And I think that this album was made in a very perfect time for me creatively, and like, yeah, it was just so natural and easy and fun and calm. Choosing singles, I don't really know why I choose the ones I choose. I just do. Like, my brain's just like, oh yeah, this one, of course. I have no clue what's gonna be big or not. I gave it up years ago, because I'm always wrong. Everything I think that people will like, they don't. And everything I think they won't like, they do. So I have no idea how it works. I don't know why people like things. I don't know why they don't. I couldn't tell you. Well, it's nice because it makes it easier for me to know that I'm not picking something because I think it'll be big. I'm genuinely picking something because I have real, actual feelings about it and believe in it on my own. And it's really about lyrics and, you know, what I'm talking about and what I feel that the fans will appreciate. And I want them to be excited about the album and, you know, I want them to see what the album could contain. I guess with Your Power, a lot of it comes from synesthesia, which I have, which I've talked about a lot. And if you don't know what it is, it's this like thing where in your brain you just associate things with other things, like colors and numbers and days of the week and all these things. To me, Your Power is this like tan brown color, and Happier Than Ever, the album as a whole, is also that color. I don't know, I thought that Your Power was a very kind of perfect middle ground for what the album felt like to me. You can listen however you want, but I would love if your car has nice speakers, or your friend's car has nice speakers, it's raining, you're in a nice car with a good sound system, and just turn it up and just recline and close your eyes and listen. That's what I hope people will do. But listen however you want, it's up to you.